Android apps today present a massive opportunity for developers. And with the mobile market emerging as a global force, to really make an impact, you have to think and act globally. Worldwide, 1 billion Android devices have been activated, with more than 1 million apps in Play Store and 50 billion apps downloaded in over 190 countries. This is a huge opportunity. My name is Manish. I'm from Google internationalization team, and I want to show you how to crack the code to engage with the next 5 billion users. Let's look at where these users are coming from. If you are developing for and targeting to only one region or a country, you're only getting a piece of the pie. In particular, with North America, you're only getting 11% of the internet users. Similarly, supporting only one language in your app gives you a fraction of the users. For example, supporting only English gives you 1/4 of the chunk. You are missing out on 75% of potential users. Now let's look at where these future users are coming from. Let's focus on year-over-year growth numbers. We observe double-digit growth for emerging markets, 26% in India, 58% for Indonesia. Compare that to 3% in the United States. Now let's look at the population penetration numbers. India at 11%, Indonesia at 23%, US at 78%. So the growth numbers for emerging markets are strong, but what is even more striking is that the room to grow is huge. Now let's look at the revenue opportunity. In Q1 of this year, Japan overtook US as the top country by revenue. South Korea is a close third. From revenue growth perspective, US is not even in the top 5 fastest growing markets. South Korea is growing nearly 9 times faster than US. Japan, with 3 times the growth of US, is set to continue its lead as a top country for revenue. Availability of apps in 190 countries is great, but which market should I enter first? What are the key considerations for you as you make those decisions? I'll give you 3 key considerations which will make your decision easier. Different markets behave differently with respect to their app consumption behavior. Certain markets are mobile pioneers, countries that are early adopters of mobile technology. Notice on the far right are many large countries like Brazil, Russia, and India, as well as some smaller but influential countries like Switzerland and Israel. Besides sharing similarities in app usage, these countries tend to lag behind in adopting mobile technologies. Another totally different consideration is effort required to support a group of languages. You can support Latin script languages easily by doing additional testing after translation. CJK, Chinese, Japanese, Korean languages need attention to font size, input, and vertical display. Bidirectional languages like Arabic and Hebrew are the most challenging. In these languages, the text goes right to left, numbers go left to right. Special attention is needed for user interfaces in these languages. Third and most important consideration is your own app key metrics. Google Play stats come in handy here. Look out for the country and the language dimensions. These show you where your users are coming from and which languages are they using. This is a strong indicator of the demand for your app and will help you decide where to localize your app. Keep your eye on the localization tips section in the optimization tips section. Here, Google does the work for you and suggests the market to target, languages to localize into. After looking at the considerations, you have decided on the markets to enter. Next, I'll give you a simple 2-step process for global success. First and foremost, localize your Play Store listing. Make sure to localize your app name, your screenshots and videos, and your app description. This will help you go a long way in your app's global success. It helps you get higher ranking and helps you maintain it as it reduces the number of uninstalls. Finally, this maximizes your search potential. This is critical as search accounts for 2/3 of all the installs, and 50% of the users search for apps weekly. Next step is to localize the experience within your app. Localization means more than just translation. Bring in the cultural aspects of the country you are targeting. Your ultimate aim is to make the users feel that the app has been created for them rather than shipped to them with some cosmetic changes. For example, here are the Hindi and the English versions of the Zombie Ragdoll app. Notice that in addition to translation of the text, the developer has changed the rocket propeller to a cricket ball, changed the dress of the character to match the traditional dress of Indian audience. When I, as a Hindi-speaking user from India, sees this in-app experience, I am more engaged as I feel this app has been created for me. We just looked at the steps needed. Now I will walk you through how Google can help you achieve this global reach. In Google I/O 2013 keynote, we announced the availability of app translation service. You can now simply go to Play Dev Console, click on the APK section to find the service. With one button click, the translation service is available to you. You can now follow 3 simple key steps for app localization. These are: upload your strings file, select the languages, choose the vendor from the marketplace. With this, you get high quality human translation of your APK, and you can make it live right from the dev console. The service was made available to all developers in November 2013. In the last 6 months, we have seen 200 million installs of the apps localized by the service. Using this service makes the process easier, cost effective, and the turnaround times reduces significantly, from weeks to days for Indian Rummy app, one of the early adopters of the service. Besides translation, internationalization is an integral part of going global. Check out our related Google I/O talk on how to get your app ready to play. If you have not embarked on your journey of going global, now is the perfect time to do it. Google is here to assist you. Go global with Google.